So let's talk about the JP Morgan report, attorney.
Let's be very careful, Karen, because it's the economy. The JP Morgan, I think it was taken out of context purposely or otherwise, but they were not referring to President-elect or the ascendancy of President-elect Bongbong Marcos. They were not. And other statements made by so-called economists, I think it should be taken in the context that it was made more of or as a political statement than from a standpoint of an economic manager or economic managers. Hanggang doon lang ang aking sasagutin sapagkat that is all about the economy.
Okay. And to be fair, I'm going to read a part of the report just so there's balance for our viewers. The JP Morgan report did say that it's the macroeconomic policies, and they flagged rising risks from high public debt and surging inflation, which of course comes from the previous administration. Mm-hmm. But they did point out certain concerns future-wise of Mr. Marcos's lack of substantive economic platform and the absence of what they call a meaningful track record. How would you respond to that, attorney? Do you think
I have said these are more political, Karen? Okay. Having the statement that you have just read, for me, it sounded more political than all economic. About economy. Yeah, it's so political.
Mm. Okay. All right. So moving forward, I mean, we're presuming Mr. Marcos will be addressing the economy anyway in the days to come. As he said, he will do it every day. Now, Fitch Solutions, on the other hand, says there will be continuity. There'll be a soft transition of power. So there's another question. Will Mr. Marcos be another Duterte?
What do you mean by that?
In other words, is it absolute continuity from President Duterte's leadership? Because you do have also some sectors, and I mean, that are quite concerned about also how Mr. Duterte treated business, treated several, example, human rights issues. So when it talks about continuity, a smooth transition of power is another thing, but how would you describe Mr. Marcos's leadership? Is it a Duterte 2.0? Or how would you describe it? Is it change?
Karen,
what is it?
Karen, last May 9, 2022, last Monday, the Filipino people, 31 million of us, voted for Bongbong Marcos. So he will have his own government, he will have his own governance, and he is his own man. Anything away from PRRD, yeah. But uh-huh. President-elect Bongbong will continue lahat ng magagandang programa ni Pangulong Duterte, specifically the build. In fact, he's been very, very vocal about this, to include the digital infrastructure in the blueprint of the build. So, as I have said again, the people voted for Bongbong Marcos last Monday. He will have his own government, he will have his own governance, and he is his own man.
Okay. Will we be hearing from Mr. Marcos in the coming days on controversial issues in terms of policy, like, for example, isabong? Or do you believe he'll wait this out until he actually sits as president?
Well, he has his thoughts on the isabong, and he is also mindful of its social costs. So, yan, pag-uusapan yan, how to balance yung the need of the government for revenue, especially now he will be faced with 13 trillion debt. But at the same time, old school talaga itong si President-elect Bongbong. He values family. So he's also looking at the downside of it, which is yung social cost. At may mga report na may mga bata na wala ng control, nagsusugal na rin.
Which is true. Which is true.
I know. So yan, binabantayan niya yan. Sa kanya, at the end of the day, hindi yung revenue pwede mong i-let go kung magsasakripisyo naman yung ating basic political unit, which is the family.